Hi and welcome back. In this video, I will share with you a simple function that I created for bulk renaming of columns. I've done bulk renaming of columns in my previous video, List.Zip, but that was with a different example. This time, I made it as a function that anyone can use for any given data. So as you can see, I have two tables here, the sample data and then the list of new column names. I've already loaded it in the Power Query. So let's create the function. I will need a blank query. So in the data tab here, get data, and then from other sources, blank query. Let's first rename it. Let's call it the function for rename call. Okay, and then on the view tab, let's use the advanced editor, remove everything on it, and then let's have the function. So we need two variables. One is your table. I call it your table as table, and new call names as a list. And then as any, and then a go to sign, and then let's start with a let. So here we need a variable that will hold the list of the column names, existing column names of your table. So I will call it call names, and then I will use table.ColumnNames, and then the table is the one that you will supply, your table. And then the other one is a combination of a list, so I will call it combined list. And I will use list.zip for that. One is the existing column names, and then the other one is the new column names. So list.zip, and then it needs a list of lists, so a curly bracket. And then the first one is the existing column names, that will be the call names. And then the other one is the new column names, so that will be the new call names, the given list that you will supply as well. And then close the list.zip, and then let's rename the column. Let's have rename call, and let's use table.RenameColumns, and then it requires a table, of course, that will be your table, and then the old and the new column names, and that will be on the combined list that we created using list.zip. That's it. Close it. Display it in rename call, and then done. Let's check it. So that's it. We have a function here. So, let's try it with our tables here, the sample table and new call names. So for the table, let's use the sample table. And then for the new column names, choose the column, choose the new call names, and then choose that particular column that you have. And then OK, invoke the function. That's it. You have this particular new column names here, Jan, Feb, and March. As you can see here, the long names are on the existing table. So that's it. So if you want to have new column names, for instance, you want to have April, May, and June instead of Jan, Feb, and March, and you don't want to go back to the spreadsheet, you can create a list here in the blank query. So let's create that blank query, and then let's have a list, curly bracket, and then let's handwrite the April in double quote April. And then also May, and then June. And then afterwards, you can wrap it with table.FromList, and that's it. Enter. There you have the list. So let's try that as well. So go back to the function. Again, we will use the sample table. For the new column names, we will use this query one. Okay, choose that. Choose the column. Okay, invoke the function. That's it. It's now on April, May, and June. And that's it. I'm finished here. I'm done. If you like this video, you can subscribe in my channel. Click the subscribe button and see you next time. And thanks.